It is an amazing love. See what manner or how great love the Father has bestowed upon you that you should be called children of God. Summoned by the King into the Master's courts, lifted by the Savior. It means that we are now led by the Spirit. Romans 8:14. All who are being led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God. You are being led by the Holy Spirit if you are a child of God. Which I take to mean this. The Holy Spirit mercifully, condescendingly, lovingly, tenderly, usually quietly, is living in you, mightily. And according to Romans 12:1 and 2, what he is doing is conforming your heart, not to the world, and your mind, not to the world, but is transforming your mind and your heart to him, to his son, to Jesus, so that your priorities are no longer the priorities of the non-children in the world. Your values are no longer the values of the non-children in the world. Your whole value system and all that you devote your life to and what moves your emotions, what drives your priorities is God. And therefore, you prove what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect, and thus he leads you. As I'm carried to the table, seated where I don't belong, carried to the table. You are now, as a child of God, different enough from the world that you shine like a light. Philippians 2:15, you are the children of God in the midst of a crooked and perverse generation among whom you appear like light in the world. The children of God are born of God that they might be light of God. Little fragment, as it were, of the character of God, broken off and refracting his light all over in their business, at the school, and in their office, and at home, and in the neighborhood, little fractions, and you know...